You've probably heard about whale fall. When a whale dies, its body falls to the ocean floor and delivers a pulse of nutrients to this deep, dark ecosystem. This natural process also carries carbon from the surface environment to the deep, where it's sequestered. Whale falls move a lot of carbon. Some estimates say that after industrial whaling reduced these mammals' populations worldwide, more than 900,000 metric tons of carbon remained in the atmosphere rather than being sequestered in whales and falling to the ocean floor. But fish fall too. Gaël Mariani, a PhD candidate at the University of Montpellier in France, wondered how much carbon was sequestered by fish fall, and if our human appetite for big fish like tuna was depriving the ocean of this carbon and sending it into the atmosphere instead. So Mariani crunched the numbers, and he found that since 1950, our take of big fish like tuna, mackerel, sharks, and billfish has released approximately 37.5 million metric tons of carbon into the atmosphere. Some of these fish would have been eaten in the upper reaches of the ocean, but more than half of the carbon, nearly 22 million metric tons, would have sunk to the seafloor in the fish's bodies. And that wasn't all. The emissions of the fleet fishing these animals was 165 million metric tons. Altogether, that's 0.2 billion metric tons of carbon into the atmosphere. So letting more big fish fall to the ocean floor when they die, as well as helping their numbers grow in the first place, could put a lot of carbon away by letting it fall.